I'm Lukasz Tvrdý, and I will be talking about brushes in Krita. Good morning, everybody, by the way. So I start. So who I am? I'm actually a student at Technical University in Ostrava, in Czech Republic. I come from Slovakia, but we used to be Czechoslovakia, so we understand each other. So I can study in Czech Republic with no problems. How did I get involved in Krita? I started with a Google Summer of Code 2008. There was some idea, implement SumiE brush engine for Krita. I didn't know what is SumiE, but basically it is a Chinese or Japanese style of painting. I like the idea. I'm a big fan of computer graphics. I like to play with algorithms and stuff, so I pick it up. I was lucky to get a slot, so it was the start. Then I get another slot next year. In 2009, I've been working on canvas improvements. I did a 3D dimensional cursor on canvas, so you can see a model of your tablet, and you can see on canvas the tilt of your pen. And I did some other improvements for canvas there. And then I decided to do a thesis because I was shortly in my final level of school, so I had to prepare. So I had to choose a topic for thesis, and I decided to do brush engines. Then I became this year 2010 a community sponsored developer. We decided to improve Krita so that it is usable for real artists. Basically for Blender people who are working on Durian. So we worked with David Revoa. He gave us some input, and we prepared some action plan with some points that we want to make. And I was working full-time 2 months and a half on Krita, and I will continue to work full-time on Krita for next 3 months also, because we have some money still. Okay, what I'm going to talk about, I will demonstrate the brush engines I implement for Krita. I implement probably around 7 or 8 brush engines, and then I will talk a little how to write your own brush engine in Krita. So what is brush engine? Basically, it is a painting operation. In GIMP, the user see brush engine as tool. It is airbrush or pixel brush or eraser or duplicate op. And in Krita, we have this kind of stuff as brush engines. So airbrush is brush engine, but we now have spray brush instead of airbrush. Pixel brush is brush engine. The duplicate tool from GIMP is a brush engine in Krita. And why is that so in Krita? Because in Krita we have tools. You can have freehand tool, and you can have line tool or rectangular tool or ellipse tool, and you can use the painting operation with these tools. My paint has one big brush engine which creates every stroke there. Okay, I will start with Hairy Brush. It was Google Summer of Code 2008 project, and the purpose was simulate SumiE style Chinese-Japanese painting. And there was one particular feature that Baudouin wanted from me. Baudouin is a Krita maintainer, and it is ink depletation. The work is inspired by Steve Stressman. He wrote a short article about Hairy Brush, and basically his idea is working in non-interactive way. It works more like a vector graphics. You define some points, and you define pressure in these points, and his algorithm render the stroke. And then there is some interactive model from Clara Chen, and you can interactively paint a SumiE style with his model, and I take inspiration from both. There is some implementation of Hairy Brush from Stressman in interactive way as Java applet, but it works only for small canvases because it works in a way that it renders the stroke, and then the clears the canvas, render it again. I kind of tried to mimic this behavior in experimental brush engine, where I clear the canvas with every stroke. It is particle-based brush engine. It means that it is not just rubber stamping of some brush footprint, but you have some particles. They have behavior. They can scale. They are oriented around the middle of the coordinate system. You drag them around the canvas, and I will show you how to create some strokes with that and what can you do with that. As I was working on this brush engine, there was some version that mimics chalk, so Bodin decided that we will have this brush engine also. So it was early stages of the hairy brush. And as the time goes, it became more general, so I renamed it from Sumier brush engine to hairy brush, because it's really particle-based and you can do much more than just simulate Sumier style Chinese painting. So let's have some demonstration. So I will select hairy brush, and we have some configuration here. First, you define some shape of the brush. Then you can scale the bristles. They are wrong color. You can scale the bristles from the center of the brush. Yeah, it became bigger this way, but I usually use small y values. Then you can change the density. This is saying how many bristles you have in your brush. If you use small number, you have less bristles in the brush. Then we have some stuff like you can turn on anti-aliasing of it, and let's make some here. It can react to the pressure of your tablet. The size of the brush can be changed by pressure, or basically we use sensors. You can have AG time to change the size. So as the time flies, it became smaller and smaller, and it repeats. So basically it's a bristle-based brush engine where you can control the bristles and create funny effects. Okay, I will go to the next brush engine. The next brush engine is spray brush. Basically it was inspired by book report. Somebody says that our airbrush sucks, so I decided to make something new and something different from usual way of doing airbrush. Basically, the airbrush in different software works like that you have some brush mask footprint with opacity, and it is graduating and creating the airbrush effect this way. I decided to implement it differently. I decided to select again particle-based model. You define some area of your brush, and you splatter some particles in that area, and the particle can be anything, texture, shape, or pixel, or anything. Then I want it to be very effective in the way of colors. Usually, when you paint, you control opacity with pressure. So I decided to add hue saturation and value. So you can control hue saturation and value by sensor, and that means you can control this stuff with pressure or some other input. And then I added some funny rotations to the particles. So when you paint, the particles are rotated in various ways, and you can create and simulate various stuff, basically various medias. I will demonstrate again. Select here are the brush engines in Krita. We plan to merge some of them because there are too many and they overlap with features. So basically you define some area by diameter. You can have a circle or elliptical shape. You can rotate it, you can scale it. It creates different effects when you change diameter and scale. Spacing is known, and you can define how many particles you want. And you can spray here. Basically, you can use any shape or pixel, or you can use a texture. I will use ellipse or lines. It will be funny. You can have a random size of the particles. And here is the funny rotation. You can use some constant rotation. So you have constant rotation. And you can have a little bit. You can have random rotation and mixed with constant. And the random, here is the weight of the random rotation. So if I give full weight, it is rotated totally random, but when I lower the weight, it is just a little bit random and mainly constant. Then you can have AG driving angle. And if you set up full weight, it just follows driving angle. You can then I can show you some color variations. You can have random HSV, you define some interval, how much you want to change the hue or saturation, and I will select random opacity, so every particle has random opacity, and I want every particle in one dab to have different color, so basically creating. Really rich color. But I don't know if you can see it, but I see it. Okay, 5 minutes. Next brush engine I did was just pure pixel brush. I was trying to reinvent the wheel and add something new. So basically I add also hue saturation value transformation to this one. I added density. It is a property that can allow you to simulate chalk and charcoal style. And what is unique is that you can set up softness of the brush by curve. It's really powerful. And you can control softness by pressure. It is not possible in pixel brushing in Krita in different brush engine. So I think this is the main features of it. I will go further. Then we have the deform brush. This was inspired by my digital image processing lesson where we learned scaling and rotation. So I just write brush engine then that takes LiDAR as input and transform it. It works similar as a GIMVRAP plugin, but they have to do to make it a tool, and they should really do it because it's much more usable. Use case, if you saw the David Reba DV, he's correcting the painting with this filter, and it's not very usable. I think Krita has deform brush, and it's much more usable for it. And you can create abstract art with that. I saw some very nice pictures from our artist, Enkitan. Then we have particle brush, but I'm running out of time, so I will show some pictures. This is the first picture I saw in August 2008. It was created with the Sumia brush engine in early stages. David Revoa created this tiger with Sumia brush engine, with Hairy brush lately. Again, our artist, Enkitan Samilanj, created fur in this image with Hairy brush. This net picture shows that you can use bugs. You can claim that bug is a feature, because I had bug in my hairy brush when the bristles were not connected. between the strokes. So he used this bug to create the rain. Yeah. This is this Sumi-e style Japanese painting, Chinese painting, created with hairy brush. Really cool. Here you can see spray brush and hue saturation value transformation is used. So it is very, colorful, more colorful with less work. It is created just with spray brush. Some Polish artist created this watercolor simulation with spray brush again. And so he used also the soft brush. In this picture, the hairs been done with particle brush I skipped, but basically it is very similar to hairy brush. David Rewa created this one with our default pixel brush, but the little details like the sand on the glass is done with my brush engine. And here is the soft brush with density feature. David Rewa just took something from his furniture, put it on the desk and painted it. Really cool simulation. I don't know how we are with time, but maybe questions, or I can talk about how to write brush engine. So what do you prefer?
Any questions by now? Yes.
Okay, so how to write the brush engine? Basically, I have to say the brush engine is plugin in Krita. 1, 2. I lost my sound. Ah, I'm back. So basically, I have to say that the brush engine is plugin. So you create a new plugin in Krita. You have to have some idea about how your painting algorithm will work. And then you have to decide if you will do something in the style of rubber stamping so that you define some shape. And you just rubber stamp it, then you just need to implement kiss paint op paint at operation, or you can define the behavior when the user is making a stroke, it is sampled into lines, and you can define the behavior in the lines and just render some shape into pixel buffer and then bitbleed it on a layer. You can access the pixel buffer through kiss painter. And basically, you bitbleed your pixel buffer you create in Painted or PaintLine. We have some two supporting libraries for you. You can we support ABR brushes, Photoshop brushes, till version 6 or 7. I'm not sure. Then we support GIMP brushes, and in Lib PaintOb you can find some GUI stuff that can help you. So you have PaintLine implemented, you defined some algorithm that render something into your pixel buffer, and then you just need to serialize the brush settings so that they can be reused. When the artist makes some settings of the brush engine, he can save it and use it later. And it is also used in recording. That's all you need to know about how to make a brush engine, I think. Any other questions?
Can you speak in the microphone?
So I wanted to know if you were happy with the API that Krita provided, or did you need patches from the Krita developers to make your brush engine happen?
When I started with Hairy Brush, Bodin was supporting me a lot, Krita maintainer, so I'm not sure what he was doing, but probably he was making something new. I was not very oriented in the development, so I didn't saw it. But basically, further, I didn't need much API improvements. I was quite happy with what I had. But there were two or three refactorments in our brush engine, mm-hmm. but just adding the features, it was good.
Thank you. We have one more question we can take. Is there anyone who wants to ask a question? Well,
thank you very much.
You'll be.
Oh.
Ah, look.
Sorry. Is it possible to reuse like your brush engines for Krita in some other paint applications? I don't know, because if I will write a brush engine, I'd like to maybe support as many applications with it. So if it's just like really application specific, for I do one thing for Krita and totally different for GIMP, or if it's like I can share the code, or I don't know, whatever.
There is no API to share the code yet, so you would basically have to port the brush engines between the applications. But it's not very hard to make it. I already ported some different code to Krita, and I think it's easy to port back to different application. I think basically you render something into pixel buffer and bitblit, so if your API allows you to render something into pixel buffer, so you are done.
Thank you very much.